I'm with Dave Bricker, a long-term sailing friend. We've crossed many an ocean to meet. And so, Dave, you were telling a story about losing the boat keys and an outcome.
Losing my boat keys. I lost the keys not only to the sailboat that was out on a mooring, I lost the keys to the dinghy that I would need to use to get to that mooring.
So how did you start to solve the problem? Because there were several options. Well, one option
was to call a locksmith, and I thought, it's going to cost me a lot of money, not only to get a locksmith to unlock the dinghy,
but he has to go back to the boat.
To row that locksmith out to the boat with whatever tools he'd have to carry.
So one of the things about being a sailor, we are very, very innovative, and now the locksmith is not going to work, so what is your next option?
The next option was the ultimate problem-solving tool, YouTube. So I went home without going to the boat, and I went out to YouTube, and went onto YouTube, and I looked up, how do you pick a stainless steel discus lock? One of those round locks with the circular mechanism on it, and the one on the boat was very well protected. Fortunately or unfortunately, depending on your perspective, I found a tutorial given by a 13-year-old kid about how do you pick a discus lock. It's extraordinarily easy. It can be done in seconds.
So you order the equipment.
I went on Amazon. I ordered a $20 set of lock picking tools, and I ordered a couple of practice locks.
And how long did it take to pick your first lock?
I think the first one took 3 minutes, and it got faster from there.
And then you went out to the boat, and you
opened the lock like nothing, and got back in, and business as usual. But I was thinking about this. All of this stuff we rely on, these locks, our front doors, our cars, we have this false sense of security. Anybody with a YouTube education can pretty much walk into your home, break into your car. We've seen tow truck drivers take a Slim Jim and pop a door open.
Exactly.
It ain't rocket surgery.
So how do you think people feel when you disclose this?
So when I tell people, I get one of two reactions. The first reaction is they're mad at me for revealing the secret, as if it was me who put the video tutorial up. And the fact of the matter is, this information is out there for the public to see and consume and use for purposes good and evil.
And all the people who are evil who are out there who are breaking into houses, they know this already.
Exactly. So, sorry, but that one's not on me. The other reaction is a little bit more interesting, and it has to do with a phenomenon called confirmation bias. We believe the stories that we most want to believe, and we trust evidence that confirms what we want to believe. When it comes to the lock, people will say, wow, their initial reaction might be, I need to go buy new locks, I need to put in a security system, I need something more sophisticated to protect my family and my home and my belongings. They think about it for a minute and they say, well, I didn't get broken into yesterday. I didn't get broken into the day before. I didn't get broken into the month, or the year,
or ever.
My security system must be working fine. This is not a problem. And they go on with their lives because they've found a logical way to circumvent that problem. The tie-in, the example you're looking for, is what are we doing with the environment? We didn't have a flood yesterday. Maybe we had a forest fire yesterday, but we've had forest fires before. We've had hurricanes before, but we didn't get 20 of them in one season.
And it was not in my exact neighborhood.
And it was somebody else's problem, right? So we go on with this idea that, well, maybe we can keep burning gas and coal, and we can keep generating carbon, and we can keep pumping this stuff into the environment because look at this beautiful garden I'm standing in. Everything is beautiful and perfect and fine. That's confirmation bias because the reality is not going to catch up with us. It's like smoking cigarettes. One cigarette, 10 cigarettes, 2 years worth of cigarettes. It's not till 10 or 20 years down the road where you're looking at your yellow fingers and yellow teeth and your emphysema and your lung cancer.
Mm-hmm.
This is confirmation bias.
Well, we have a lot to think about. We have a lot to re-look at the same issue from different perspectives. So thank you, Dave, for sharing our boating story and coming back a full circle from the sea to what do we have to do to actually look at our environment from another perspective to protect this future. This is not a future about ourselves. This is a future about the next generation.
Thanks, Neil.